Recently, I have got a lot of comments on how to create jQuery image slider. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to do that, and also I will add slideshow functionality to this slider. So let's do it. Hey, what's up guys? Senaid here from coolingpassiveincome.com, the place where I help others to become a web developer much easier and faster than they will do it on their own. So if that is something that interests you, consider subscribing. So before we even dive into the code and start writing, I want to explain you the basics that you need to understand for this tutorial. So our goal is to create a normal HTML document, and inside that document we will have one block of the code. So let's say like this, and this will be our slider. And inside this slider we will just put a lot of the pictures. So let's say we have this, really it's not important how many of those we have. And our goal is that all the images inside this slider are hidden. So for example, we will hide all those and only visible picture will be this one, okay? And now we will have some buttons here. So let's say previews, slideshow, next. And when someone press, for example, next button, we are going to hide this image and we will show this image. If he press next again, we will hide this, show this, and so on. And the same thing is with the previews button. And the only difference is if we have slideshow, so when someone press that button, what we are going to do, we will actually just every second, two, or whatever time you want, we will just switch the image. So we'll hide, show, and so on. So pretty much that's it. It's extremely basic, and most tutorials that I have seen really complicate those things. So let me show you how to write the code. So now I'm here at my PHP store. I have created a new project, and inside this project I have new folder images, and I have one index.html file which contents you can see here. So the images, there are just 5 images, some random images, nothing special, you can have as many as you want. So before I start writing the code, for those of you that are interested to download source code for this tutorial, you will find a link in the description below. So the first thing is I will just use the center to center all elements to the center of the page. This is a deprecated HTML tag, so it's better to use CSS to make it, but for the purpose of this tutorial it's not important. So I will say div, I will add class slider, and inside this div I will just include, say like this, 5 images, okay. And down below I will just add 3 buttons. So this one will be previous, another one will be next, and this one will be start slideshow. So let's see what we have. So as you can see here, there are just 5 random images and there are 3 buttons. So what I'm going to do, I will just write some CSS. Okay, so first I will set the background for our body to the black. For the slider image, I'm going to hide all images, so I will say like this. And then inside the slider I will also have one class active, and that one will have display block, and let's say the border will be 2 pixels solid white. And basically this active class, we will just move from one to another image, and where is he positioned, that picture will be visible. So I will say here active. So let's check that. Okay, now of course those buttons doesn't work, but as you can see, we have the class active on this image and it's visible. So if we move it, for example, here, let's refresh, there is another image, and so on. We can just try again. Yeah, so every time there is a different image. And let's say for the slider, I will say margin top 10%, just to make it. So yeah, so this is looking good. Okay, so I will just do this. And now we need to write some jQuery code that will make a functionality for those buttons. So first we need to include it. So I will just go to the code.jquery.com. Here you have a list of all the versions of the jQuery. I'm going to use the latest one at the moment. And I will just copy this and paste it just before closing body tag, like this. And now I will just write our script here, text JavaScript, and that's it. So here I'm going to have two functions. So first function will be change slide, which will be functionality for the previous and the next button. And let's say the parameter that will receive will be direction. And I'm going to have another function, which will be slideshow. And let's say the parameter will be color, so that we know which button is pressed, so that we can manipulate this value. So we can say start or stop or something. Okay. So let's say first we are going to make next button. So here I will say on click, change slide, and here direction will be next. So that means that inside this function we need to check for direction. So if direction equal next, we will execute this part of the code, otherwise we will execute this part of the code. Now we need to get the position of the active image that is shown. So we will do it by defining new variable, let's say current image for img equal dot active. Okay, and now the next image we will find from the current image dot next, and this is a method from the jQuery that enables us to find a next element. So inside here, if direction equal next, we will check if we have next image. If next image dot length, we will just move this active class to this next image. So that we will say just next image dot add class active. And we need to remove this class from the current image. So we will just say here current image dot remove class active. So let's try it. Fresh, next, next. And the problem here is we don't have any more images. So there isn't next, And for that reason, I'm checking here. So if there isn't next, we will say else, and we will position ourselves to the slider image dot first, which means go to the slider, find images, select first image, which is this one, and then just add class to that first image, like this. And let's make a test. So next, and now as you can see, it is always working. So if we go to the inspect element to see what is happening, now we can see that active class is just going from one image to another. Okay, very simple. And the same functionality we are going to make for this previous button. So we can just duplicate this. We'll call method prep, and here we'll say previous image, and down below I will copy this, paste. Now we will just change this image to the previous image, and here we will say go to the last image. So when we're going backwards, where we start on the first image and there isn't any less image, then we will go again to the biggest image. So let's test. So now previous doesn't work. Let's see what is the problem. Not taking the console log. Let's see. So the problem is that we didn't define onClick method for this button. So let's try now. And yes, now it is working. Okay. So if we check with the previous, we are going backwards, and the next we are going forward. So it is pretty simple. So now, in order to make a slideshow, all we need to do is just to call this function change slide every second or two. So we can say here var interval. So we are defining new variables so that we later can disable it. And we will say here set interval. So this function receive a function and a time when this function here will be called again. So if you set 1000, it will need every second. So I'll say here function, and inside this function I'm going to say change slide, and let's say the direction is next. And here for this button we will set on click slideshow, and the color is this. So let's try, you hit start slideshow. Now as you can see, every second the image is changing, but we don't have a way to stop it. So first I will just set this to 2 seconds, so it's not too fast. And here I will define new variable stop slideshow false, and here I will say if stop, if not stop slideshow, then change slide, else clear interval, which means that if we didn't start stop the slideshow, we will move to the next slide, and if we stop it, then this interval will be cleared and this function here won't be called every 2 seconds. Okay, and now we just need to find a way to manipulate with this. So we can simply check for this value. So if this is start, it means that we will start slideshow. So this stop slideshow will be false, and if it's stop, the stop slideshow will be set to the true. So let's say var status equal color dot attribute value, and we can say if status dot index of start bigger than -1. So it means if there is word start inside this value, it means that our stop slideshow will be false. And also we are going to change the value of this color. So say stop slideshow. And the same principle is for this. So say true. And here we will say start. So let's make a test. Now if we hit start slideshow, as you can see now, the word has changed to the stop slideshow, and every 2 seconds there's a new image. And now if we stop, it stopped, and also the word is back to the start. So that is very, very simple to do. So now the last thing I'm going to show you is just how to make those buttons a little bit nicer. And for that purpose, I will use Bootstrap CSS. So I will just go to getbootstrap.com and copy this. Okay. And here I will just define class button, button primary. I'll copy this there, and here I will say success. So let's see. As you can see now, it's looking really nice. Okay, and of course it is working. And now if we press this, it will work, but as you can see, there's always green color. So it will be nice to change this color. So that is very simple. So I will go here and say color dot add class btn danger dot remove class btn success, and the same thing here. So we will remove danger and set success. Okay, refresh. Now if you press start, you can see that this is changing, and if we click again, it is changing. So guys, pretty much that's it. Now you have nice looking but very simple jQuery image slider. If you like this video, please like it and share it to your friends. And also, if there is any question or there is anything that you don't understand, please let me know in the comments below. Take care.